be talking about how God gave us salvation as how we learn in the Bible study. Initially, God didn't come to save us as we were Gentiles, but came to save the Israelites because that's who he was sent for. But when they rejected God's invitation on coming to heaven, God looked upon the Gentiles with favor and saw that more than his own people, the Gentiles wanted to seek God. An incident in Matthew 15:21-28 tells us that a Canaanite woman came to Jesus seeking him wholeheartedly. At first, God ignored her because he came for the Israelites and walked by the woman. But the woman kept following her, kept following him persistently and asking him to save her daughter. Then, after a few minutes of this going on, Jesus stopped and said, "What good is it to give the children's bread to the dogs?" Then the woman answered, "Yes, Lord, that is true, but even the dogs eat what fall from their master's table." God was astonished with this answer and said, "O woman, your faith is great. Let it be as you have desired." The Israelites had rejected God because they only wanted the miracles from him and didn't seek him as their God. But the Gentiles had found favor with God. There is another parable about a king and a son and some servants and some guests. The guests symbolize the Israelites. The servants symbolize the prophets. The king symbolizes God. And the son symbolizes Jesus. The parable is about a king who invited all the guests for his son's wedding, but they rejected it as they didn't come. This means they are not only rejecting the king, but the son as well. This is symbolizing the fact that the Israelites had an invitation to heaven, but they rejected it. So, continuing the story, when the king saw that they rejected his invitation, he said to take all the beggars off the road and force them to come, because if the messengers had said to them they were invited to the king's party, then they would think, "Why am I invited? I'm just a strange beggar on the road. What did I do that has pleased the king?" And therefore they would not attend the party, as they also didn't have a garment to wear. So the king said to force them into the castle, and that is what the king is doing to us. He loves us dearly and wants fellowship with us, but that is not the end. He told everyone to wear a garment to the party that he would give them, and everyone came wearing a wedding garment to the party except one man. He thought that the garment wasn't good enough, and so he wore something else. When everyone was gathered at the feast and everyone was eating, the king came and saw the man not wearing the garment. And when he was questioned about why he was not wearing the garment, the man was speechless. Thus, he was thrown out into the outer darkness, where there was weeping and gnashing of teeth. Our own garment is self-righteousness, our good character, and even evangelism is like filthy rags. We have to believe that Jesus died on the cross for our sins, and then only will we be wearing the garment of salvation and the robe of righteousness. God is not unjust, and he gives everyone a second chance. Us Gentiles are only accepted by believing that Jesus died on the cross for our sins. God is merciful and gives everyone a second chance. If we believe in him, then we can go to heaven.